Show 21, continuing our Rockies rebuild. And I just want to say thank you for the support on the first video with this. That was really cool to see, and I'm glad everybody enjoyed it. Hopefully you enjoy this one. Hopefully you find it relaxing. And if you do enjoy the content and aren't or are new, please consider subscribing to the channel, as of course it would help us to grow. Almost at 250 subs, but we're looking to just keep growing and expanding the community within the channel. So again, hope you all enjoy, and let's get into this rebuild. So we're gonna pick up here at the trade deadline, so July 31st, and the first thing we're going to do in just a moment is I'm gonna show you guys the trades that we ended up making. Now I did do a bit of an overhaul here. So the first trade is going to be for Ryan Yarbrough and Willy Adames from the Tampa Bay Rays for Senzatella, who was really struggling for us, Garrett Hampson struggling as well, and Brendan Rodgers, who was blocked by Trevor Story. So Adames will take over for Hampson at second base, since Story is at shortstop, and Yarbrough will slide in very nicely into the rotation. Now the second trade that we're going to be making is Alex Verdugo from apparently the New York Mets for three prospects. Matsumoto, I think we, if I remember correctly, I was going to say we got him in the draft. I think we picked him up in free agency. The third trade with the White Sox, we're going to give up Derek Rodriguez, Grant Levine, who's a top prospect at first base, and Rolison for Aaron Bummer. Just he should be a really nice, solid arm in the bullpen for us moving forward, as we do want to address our pitching. So that might be it. We did get an offer from the Minnesota Twins for J.A. Happ in exchange for Michael Givens, but it didn't really fit what we were looking to do, so we did end up declining on that one. So we're going to continue into the second half of the year here and see how we're doing. Now again, you know, we're not really doing that great. We're in last place, 42 and 66. You can see, I don't even know what I'm doing here. Oh, it looks like we're calling up a Brinsenio. Okay, so we'll make this little change, but you can see that we're not really performing well, and that's to be expected. We're not really in a position to play well. We're starting to get some pieces, especially with those trades that we made, but we have made it to the end of the year here. We went 64-98, so obviously no postseason for us in 2021, although, like I said, the future is looking pretty good. Now, we'll take a look at the awards, and yeah, we'll just see some of the major awards. You can see Richard Newman, who is on our team. We picked him up in free agency again prior to the season starting. Actually, ended up winning the Rookie of the Year, as you can see. Some of the other award winners in their respective categories and leagues. I don't know. I hope you guys enjoy looking at the stats. I really like it as we go through some of the league leaders here. You know, if this is something you don't enjoy seeing, let me know. I try to, like, put in the more important parts of the year as best I can without making the video too long or without cutting it too short. But I'm a huge numbers guy, so I absolutely love looking at all the stats, and, you know, for whatever reason, it kind of, you know, fascinates me numbers. So, you know, I don't know if you guys feel the same way or what, but, you know, for me, some of the most enjoyable parts of playing this is just seeing the stats that people put up, and just being able to see the different numbers, you know. And real quickly, I do have some noise in the background, so it might show up in here, it might not, I'm not sure until I edit it, but hopefully it isn't too distracting for you guys. So as we're going through here, I'll go through each video. I'll go through the National League, and then I'll go through the American League, or vice versa, so you guys can get an idea of everybody here. See if any of your favorite players in real life made the cut here in the league leaders. See how they did. And you can see that we are improving a little bit, currently ranked 19th overall. Definitely, I'm trying to remember what we were in the beginning of the year. I forget exactly. But definitely improving a little bit. So we didn't have the worst record, which is always good to do if you're trying to, if you know you're going to play bad, because you get that number one pick. But, you know, third pick overall, that's not too bad either. I'll take that. So go in and take a look at our players and see how they did. So Cole Hamels, we actually ended up sending down, and he didn't have too bad of a year. He's got almost 2,700 strikeouts. Michael Givens, they sent down. We'll adjust that. I didn't mean for that to happen. The game tends to take things into their own hands, apparently, but Givens didn't have too bad of a year as well. But Rui no struggled, so hopefully he can turn it around moving forward. Here we go to the Major League squad. Shane Green definitely struggled in that closer's role, so maybe that's not the right position to put him in. Bummer did well. Estevez did amazing since calling him up. Olberg just has had a really nice career as a reliever the past few years for Colorado, which you don't necessarily expect, but nice year by him. Very nice year by Robertson. Goldbreath started a few games for us. Jeffers had a nice year, and Stevenson had a great year, so the bullpen was actually a strength of ours. I know I mentioned we needed to address the pitching staff, but as a whole, I think that's fairly important. We started, you know, in a bad spot. As you can see, Freeland had a pretty solid year, bounced back a bit, and we just wanted to make sure we kind of built it up a little bit, so I think we're doing that. John Gray really struggled, and, you know, I'm really considering just kind of letting him go. You know, struggled pretty bad for two straight years. I don't really want to pay him what he's going to want, so we might look to let him go. Austin Gomber, he did a little bit better in the bullpen and struggled a bit once he went into the rotation, but not horrible, especially for Colorado. Yarbrough, a solid pitcher for us, 3.51 ERA. And then we have Marquez, who was hurt for a little while. That's why he doesn't have quite the amount of innings or games started, but 4.32. You know, not the best, but not the worst. So, you're not too upset with him. We take a look at some of the hitters here. Brinsegno went 0-for-7. Just had a little bit of playing time in the majors. Chris Owings didn't really do too great. He is a free agent. We might look to bring him back as a depth piece. the starter, and then we got Newman, who of course won the Rookie of the Year, so that was really nice to see. Hopefully he continues to improve from here on out. And here we go, we're gonna sim a little bit through the offseason, the playoffs, and we'll take a look. The Astros, unfortunately, I don't know how you feel about the Astros, but they beat Milwaukee in the World Series, so nice to see Milwaukee there. A little bit of a different vibe to the World Series. You can see the different brackets here that led to that outcome. Nice to see my New York Mets in there. Alright, so we're going to go into the offseason a little bit here. And of course, we will address our coaches and scouts at some point before the next season starts. Unfortunately, Daniel Barr does retire due to his injury. I was hoping he didn't, but definitely went out on a really high note. That 108 ERA, pretty good. So, great comeback by him. Unfortunately, it ended a little early, but nice to see him back. We know Cole Hamels here. Almost 2,700 strikeouts. He had a 50 WAR. You know, I personally don't like him as a player, but I respect that he's pretty good. So we'll see what happens with him making the Hall of Fame. Ramon Russell. He actually works in San Diego studios. So F potential. Wow. Okay. Not doing himself any favors there. Got Nelson Cruz retiring. Oh man, I don't think he's going to retire yet. I think he's going to get to 500 homers for sure. As long as he doesn't retire, of course. Anybody else? Anybody else? I see a couple of familiar names here. Ross Detweiler, Pat Vendit, the switch pitcher. Hector Neris here. Great. Not surprised to see him retiring here. Wellington Castillo. Jordy Mercer. Who else? I wonder if Chase DeYoung. Oh no, wait. I was going to say, is he related? Adam Wainwright is retiring. So he had a nice career. Asdrubal Cabrera. An ex-Met. Stephen Vogt. It doesn't look like it. I'm not going to go through the, players who weren't on a team, because there's going to be a lot of players there to go through. sign. Starling Marte always tends to go to the Phillies in this game, as well as last year's game. The Brewers bring in Baez for a insanely cheap contract. Holy cow. I mean, I don't think he'll be getting a ton of money, but he'll be getting a good amount. Not $28 million, that's for sure. And who else? Was there anybody else here? Alright, so we got the Cubs replacing Baez with Corey Seager, coming off a crazy, crazy good year. 5 years, $144 million. So pretty nice deal for him. Going to Chicago. And then we got the Diamondbacks acquiring Brandon Lau for a couple prospects there. I know Corbin Carroll's a pretty high-rated prospect. Brandon Lau is another guy that the game loves to trade. I remember last year in the offseason, he would get traded 3 or 4 times in one offseason. It was crazy. But here we have the new arrivals, so to speak. So we got Noah Syndergaard on a big deal. He was our big pickup. We also brought in Joaquim Soria, Roberto Osuna, and Dominguez. We got in the row 5, we have Danny Henderson, Wilson Ramos, Matt Duffy as a utility role. Who else? We brought in Michael Conforto as a big offensive piece, and Jay Bruce. Sorry, I went so fast through that. So yeah, we actually did quite a lot as we look to fill in our coaching staff here, as well as our scouts right after this. But one thing I'll mention before we even get to it, yeah, usually, you know, especially if I'm doing a video like this, in this format, just to make it a little more relaxed for myself even, like I said in the last video, I will put the budgets, I'll turn them off, but I'll try to stay positive. The only problem is it didn't dawn on me where I completely missed it, but as you can see, we're pretty far negative, and I'm just letting you guys know, because I tried to do it realistic, and I kind of made a little bit of a mistake here, and was unaware of how much money I spent, so that doesn't usually happen. I do try to keep it realistic, so moving forward, we will try to keep it realistic, but that completes the off-season. I hope you guys enjoyed. I know it was a little quick, but we'll have another video coming out to continue this rebuild. And again, I hope everybody's doing well. I hope you enjoyed and found it relaxing. And until the next one, guys, I will see you.